Iowan. This is KRUI, Iowa City.
The temperature is 9 degrees, and for KRUI, this is the latest news with Allison Bump and Alex Parrott. This Thursday, we have some big headlines. The ISIS terrorist known as Jihadi John has been identified. The University of Iowa has plans for the biggest dorm on campus, and the gas tax in Iowa will soon be increasing.
The masked face of terror in the ISIS execution videos has been identified. British security officials confirmed this morning that the man behind the mask is Muhammad Emwazi, a 27-year-old British citizen. Emwazi was born in Kuwait but grew up in London and graduated from the University of Westminster before moving to Syria in 2012. He has appeared in several beheading videos of American and British prisoners under the moniker Jihadi John. Britain estimates that at least 500 of its citizens are active militants in Syria and Iraq. In the United States, authorities arrested two Brooklyn men attempting to flee the country to fight alongside ISIS. A third man who helped with funding was also arrested. The three men were former immigrants of the Soviet Union, and at least two of them promised to carry out attacks on the United States. The men expressed online support for ISIS, but drew attention from FBI last summer.
The University of Iowa is ramping up efforts to make room for incoming undergraduate students. A new dorm set to open in the fall of 2017 will be the largest on campus. The East Side dorm will be 12 stories tall and will hold more than 1,000 students, more than twice as many as the new Peterson Hall currently under construction. Although the dorm will be built on land that saw severe flooding in 2008, designers say it will be a fully protected building.
Gas will be a little more expensive for Iowans come Sunday morning. Governor Terry Branstad signed a bill yesterday to raise the tax on gasoline by 10 cents a gallon, the first increase in 25 years. The hike will provide around $215 million annually for Iowa roads and bridges. One of the first projects on the docket is the expansion of Highway 20.
NBA star LeBron James says to stop recruiting his son. 10-year-old LeBron James Jr. has received letters and even scholarship offers from college basketball coaches despite him being in just fourth grade, and his father is not thrilled. James said, "It should be a violation. You shouldn't be recruiting 10-year-old kids." Despite LeBron's beliefs, NBA rules allow college coaches to monitor prospective players before reaching high school.
The United States could be without the Department of Homeland Security if Congress does not pass a funding bill by Saturday. Without the bill, some of the department will shut down, but most employees will continue to work unpaid. The Senate may take the bill to vote today after dropping strict illegal immigration provisions, legislation President Obama promised to veto had it passed. The bill would still need to pass in the House by Friday at midnight to prevent a partial Homeland Security shutdown.
United Airlines has issued a stern warning to its pilots after mistakes in the cockpit put passengers in danger. An incident mentioned in the warning gave details that a pilot was forced to use an emergency pull-up maneuver to avoid hitting the ground. A United Airlines spokesman says their goal is to get passengers to their destinations safely.
Break out your pens and quills, Harry Potter enthusiasts. A letter-writing campaign is underway to bring author J.K. Rowling to the University of Iowa campus next spring. The UI Lecture Committee asked students to write letters to Rowling, asking her to visit and describing your appreciation for her work. Letters can be dropped off at the Iowa Memorial Union, room 145, until March 13th.
Shoveling snow isn't the most fun job, but for a man in New Hampshire, it almost turned deadly. Drew Mullins was clearing snow from his roof when he accidentally created an avalanche that buried him in over 2 feet of snow for more than 3 hours. Firefighters worked for 20 minutes to free Mullins after his wife discovered him pinned to the ground by snow. Mullins said he knew he would make it out with will and determination for his wife and two daughters.
Finally, a quick look at the weather forecast for Iowa City. Today, we're looking at mostly sunny skies with steady temperatures near the upper single digits with 10 to 15 mile per hour winds. Right now, the temperature is 9 degrees. Stay tuned for our sports show up next, and we look forward to having you back for the news at 5. For KRUI News, this is Allison Bump and Alex Parrott.